How does his leg get under the gun? You would fall over it. I don't have an assault rifle, but we've got this set up so it's propped up like an assault rifle. Now, if I drop dead right now, would my foot go under this pretend assault rifle? Let's see. Pretending to drop dead. And no, my foot would knock the gun and not fall under it. So he was dead. And someone's put the gun over his foot. Do you think someone put the gun over his foot? Or do you think he just tripped and his body went into some really weird AI motion and, the leg just went nit 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 up under the gun like after he died, so. Oh, look, a note next to the body. How convenient. And, if he was supposed to be a spray and pray shooter, why are there absolutely no marks on the walls? Carpet looks nice and vacuumed, like housekeeping's been doing a good job keeping that hallway nice and tidy. Not one mark around it whatsoever, so the whole idea that he fired down the hallway, being a spray and pray shooter, and there's not one mark down it. That's a bit odd, isn't it? In the 3 months that I worked as a housekeeper inside a fairly decent hotel myself, not once in my wildest dreams would I leave a dirty cart outside a room. A catering cart like this is used along a round, and the hotel housekeeping will, do a round and collect all dishes and shit, and then they'll come back around like 20 minutes, half hour later, and do a round with a quick dustpan and brush and a vacuum and a cleaning cart, which again, housekeepers have their carts with them at all times. The whole idea of an upmarket hotel just leaving a filthy trolley outside the door, what an absolute load of shit. And another very strange anomaly can be seen here, when you look at this picture, which is the picture of the deceased, the accused, shall we say. There is a bit of a strange dotted blood trail. Bear with me, excuse me while I move the thing. So you can see a dotted blood trail. Disturbingly, there are two separate layers of blood, which you can see if I zoom right in on the big screen. You can see a. Shit, that doesn't work too well. You can see this big area of fresh and old shit. We'll use the caulking gun here. Now you can see the old shit to the left and to the right, where, that what appears like it would be blood has, had a bit of time to seep into the carpet. And then as we go back a little, you can clearly see what looks like a fresh area that I've highlighted there with the caulking gun. So this is all fresh that's pouring out over old. And I'd probably even go as far as saying that he's, well and truly carked. But I'd go as far as saying you've probably had like what appears to be an entry and exit wound along the front of the face. You can see immediate swelling and trauma to that area above his right eye. And I'm skeptical if, such an injury, like a bullet going in through your nose and out through your the bridge of your nose, would kill you, because I'm living proof that such lacerations wouldn't kill you. When I had my accident, fucking the entire side of my head was pretty much gone from where I'd slid down the road on my head. And here I am still making this video 6 years later. So just strange how you've got the Just pan the camera away from the deceased a moment. Ain't it strange? You got all the fresh shit pouring out over the dry. And then some rounds. Evidently the rounds are there beforehand, because you can see where the material, all the blood's flowing and gone around. And on this one here, you can see where blood sort of splashed up the face of the round and gone around the, flowed around the round there. But it's just so weird, isn't it? These particular anomalies, and how there's absolutely no clear anything in terms of what's going on, and what the authorities are up to with it. I think it's a bit suspicious, if you ask me. Just a bit suspicious.